Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? I would normally not do a video about a given planet until it is close to or just past opposition, because that way it puts it into the evening sky early enough that we can see it generally from the beginning of the evening all the way through into the morning. However, I'm going to make an exception because Mars is really only close to Earth about every 26 months. It was last closest to Earth in July of 2018, and it will be closest to Earth again on October 6th, 2020. However, it generally spends a lot of its time between those periods being very, very, very small, often somewhere in the 4 to 6 arc seconds across range, which makes it very tiny and very difficult to see much of anything as far as details on it. Doesn't put it that much larger than how we would see Uranus in a telescope, so not very big. However, right now it is 3 to 4 times that size, so it is a good time to start looking for it. So how do we want to do that? Well, for me at least, at 40 degrees north latitude, Mars is high enough above the horizon that I would be able to start taking a look at it at about 11:30 in the evening. And you can check and see what that would be best for you by clicking on the azimuthal grid here. And you get 15 degrees or higher. That's really going to be the better way to be able to see it. You're looking through a lot less atmosphere. Even 10 degrees is going to be okay. But anything lower than that, you're looking through a lot of that muck, and it makes it difficult to see features and get a steady image. So the later you can look and the higher up it will be, the better for you. So start with that for beginners. And secondly, you definitely want to employ as many good planetary observing techniques as possible, because Mars is not as big as Jupiter. Jupiter is like 45 to 50 arc seconds across typically. Mars right now, check this out, we're looking at an apparent diameter of 17. And it's really only going to get up to about 22 right now, when in October, so less than half the size of what Jupiter is. So that's small, not a lot of angular diameter there to work with. But it's a great planet because there's some cool surface features to be able to see, and other things that you may want to try to take a look at. So let's zoom in on Mars, and I want to show you how much it's going to change. So if we go like ridiculously large here, you will very likely not see Phobos and Deimos, the moons of Mars, because they are ridiculously faint. But when we look at the planet over the course of the next couple months, see how this apparent diameter is 17.6 about right now. So if we skip ahead a month to September, you can see how much larger it got. Our apparent diameter now is almost 22 arc seconds. And then when we get even into, actually I'm going to back up just a couple weeks here because it gets even bigger there on the 6th. This is our largest, closest point. We got 22, almost 0.6 arc seconds across. We're actually looking at fractions of an arc second, which if you've done any double star observing, you know is not a lot of angular distance to look at through a telescope. So you need aperture if possible. And you also want to have steady skies in front of you. So if you can avoid heat rising in front of you, like driveways or someone else's roof or your own roof, if you can look across a grassy field or a pond or the ocean, if you happen to live near there and that's the direction that Mars is going to be, that's going to give you some of the steadier views possible. So you've got a month and a half, 2 months to get a nice view of this particular planet. To see a little bit of what's happening on there, I'm going to back up just a month or so, we can see how, because Mars's rotation is just slightly different than Earth, it moves just a little bit every night as you go forward. So this particular feature right here, Syrtis Major, is very often one that we're trying to look for. It's a fairly prominent one. It's fairly well known. And we also would then be looking for, and if I remember my Mars geography correctly, this is the South Pole, and I believe that's the North Pole. So I believe we would want to be looking for a polar cap here, which is going to look white. Very often you'll see some clouds there too from the atmosphere. And sometimes you can even see clouds along some of the other areas along the edges, or even over this particular feature near Syrtis Major. I believe this is Hellas, if I'm remembering correctly. And we can sometimes see clouds along there. So early September, that might be a good time to see that if you're looking very early in the morning. I have that at I had that at 1:30 in the morning, so let's actually back up and see where we wind up. So maybe end of August, Syrtis Major might offer up some pretty good options there. And then as we spin back around, we can see how towards the latter part or the beginning of October we would have that again. So that's a good one to be able to see. Now, one way to enhance some of those features is to use filters. And I normally don't use a lot of colored filters when I do planetary observing. However, this is one planet where if you happen to have them, they may be useful. So a red filter, and let me actually put up a little piece of paper there so you can see. So the red filter is gonna help you see some of those Maria features. I actually find, oddly enough, that a green filter does a really nice job. I don't know if you can see the green here. There's the green of that, like that. The green does a nice job because what it does is it will really help the polar caps kind of pop out, especially clouds and things. And another one that might be good is an 82A light blue filter. That one can also be helpful for seeing the polar caps as well. So any of those three are useful. Even if you only have one, give it a shot. What I very often do is I will take have my eyepiece and then just take the filter and put it between my eye and the eyepiece, just holding it with my hand, because then I can see the difference between what the filtered view looks like and the unfiltered view, rather than taking the eyepiece out and screwing it on, putting it back in, refocusing or whatever. This way, you can start to learn to see some of those features without even using the filter. The filter just helps it pop out, but all those details are almost always there. You just notice them more when a filter kind of blocks some of the wavelengths of light. But then those features being already visible, then you can start boosting some of that magnification and see some more of those details on the red planet. And let me know what you see. Send me an email. You can reach out to me on Facebook, or you can post something to Twitter and let me know what you found and what you've seen. And if you, especially if you happen to take any photos of it, definitely share those with me as well. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.